Now, I've been given only 10 minutes, but probably I have missed some slides because of the time factor. So pardon me for that. There are two evidence-based age categories in fracture neck femur. The young is 16 to 65, as told by Sivanovsky in 2008, and old is above 65, which may be elderly and young elderly. That's how we must have your in your mind before you start your treatment. And based on, this is based on the patient physiological age, not the chronological age. Young is always high energy trauma, a good bone stock. Arthroplasty is a poor choice. The goal of treatment must be joint preservation. That's a very simple thing to remember. Old is low energy trauma, have multiple comorbidities, community ambulator very active as a type 1 individuals, home ambulator, home bound, and type 2 type of old people. In young patients, as usual, you have to have the protocol, but you have to have the ipsilateral fracture septal femur and neck of femur. It's about 9% that one must remember when you're doing fracture neck of femur as well. And the classification, as all of you are aware, I've been Powers type 1, carotid type 1 and 2. I will not go into the details about it. And the current classification is undisplaced. That's the current classification we use. And for any undisplaced fracture, any age group, a 3 compressions group on an urgent basis is very important. A displaced fracture, a closed or open reduction of the fracture, an internal fixation with 3 compression screws on an emergent basis to preserve and regain the blood supply. Again, we'll come to that again later on regarding the time factor. Now, early fixation decreases osteonecrosis and increases functional outcome as told by Fiona's ACLS 1984. Now, as it was et al. In 2012, he said no difference in rates of osteonecrosis whether you do it 6 hours post-injury or 48 hours post-injury. But the current surgery strategy is treat displaced fracture neck femur on an emergent basis, not on an urgent basis. If the patient comes at 7 o'clock in the evening, tomorrow morning at least by 8 o'clock you must do the case on an emergent basis. Again, the surgeon's factors again is very important. I will not go into details about it because the injection limbs will be left shortened and external rotated when the patient awaits surgery. Because the intracapsular pressure changes in the hip position in patients with a fractured neck of femur. Again, intracapsular pressure is highest when the hip is in extension and external internal rotation. Decreases substantially when the hip is in flexion and external rotation. Now that again is very important because olden days we were taught when we were in Liverpool, the limb must be kept in internal rotation as soon as possible. That was Wainwright used to say. Now we know that this must be kept in external rotation. Again, close reduction and whether open or closed. Now, obtaining anatomic reduction is very important. You have to have the lower S-shaped curves and also the Gordon's alignment index, which I will not go into details about it. And again, open reduction. If the alignment is not acceptable in your C-arm, you must actually open reduction. Open reduction must be done using the Watson Jones approach. It facilitates direct visualization for anatomic reduction. Provide relief of a past possible intracapsular tampon automate, which will come out again later, come again later on. And the varus position is not acceptable. That is very important. This patient had a varus position acceptable with the surgeon and went in for non-union. Now again, hematoma decompression is controversial. Fracture hematoma increases the intracapsular pressure. Capsulotomy reduces the pressure and thereby increase femoral head blood flow. Now that has been studied by various authors, by Shivanashki, Thomas, Hartware, Homer, and all that. So again, another paper from Upadhyay in 2004, he found there no difference in the rate of osteonecrosis with capsulotomy and without capsulotomy and internal fixation. So whether capsulotomy one has to do it or not, it's up to you to decide on with your experience and also reading the literature on it. Now again, there is a paper by Crystal et al. C-arm guided capsulotomy. When you do a close reduction, you can do a C-arm guided capsulotomy. But I believe in gastrotomy. After listening to Shivnaski in Ganga Hospital in 2012, we have been doing it and we have got very good results. Again, choice of concept, again, called it compression screw. Force screw, again, shown to have superior biomechanical stability, especially in push combination, as Sarkin and Satish, our friend from Coimbatore, studied in 2015. And this is a patient who had a displaced fracture, became 40 years old. We did a capsulotomy as well, went in for good union. This is another case fixed with the four screws. Again, sliding skip screw. Again, greater load to failure and compared less to displacement with cannulated screws. There is a study by Blair et al. So one can do adhesives as well if you want to do it. But again, the choice of concept, I mean in et al. In 2007, locking plate was the stronger and most stable concept compared to CS cannulated screws or DHS or DCS. But we don't use it in clinical practice yet, except for unstable trochanteric and subtrochanteric fractures. Complications, as you know, avascular necrosis and non-union, but they are all inherent in fracture, the surgeon's factors and patient's factor, which I will not go into the details about it because of time constraint. Young elderly, in undisplaced fracture neck of femur, ideal is internal fixation with the cannulated screws or DHS. In displaced fracture neck of femur, internal fixation invariably fails and the revision rate is very high. Internal fixation versus THA. Meta-analysis of Bhandari et al. In 2003, that is how the whole thing, concept of internal fixation changed in elderly people, and that is the eye-opener for all the surgeons throughout the world by this meta-analysis by Bhandari. He has showed high risk of revision surgery with internal fixation. Meta-analysis of 2,289 patients by Rogmark in 2004, primary arthroplasty is better. The current best evidence supports primary arthroplasty in the young elderly. Which is the best arthroplasty perform in the young elderly? Hemiarthroplasty, where of astabulum and pain is there in most of the cases. Total hip arthroplasty, ideal. Dislocation risk is there. However, this can be minimized by lab. That is the risk of dislocation when you go through the post approach. Ravi Kumar and Marsh in injury 271 patients, 13 years follow-up, pain, 48% at 1 year after hemiarthroplasty, 6% in THA, and reoperation rate, 24% hemiarthroplasty and 7% only in THA. And higher skip score, improved to 80% THA, only 50% in hemiarthroplasty. With that, you can see that the hemiarthroplasty is not so good for young elderly. And again, 120 patients studied comparing THA and hemiarthroplasty, favored THA as high risk score better than hemiarthroplasty. Bipolar hemiarthroplasty versus unipolar hemiarthroplasty. Again, existing literature suggests cemented modular bipolar hemiarthroplasty are better than cemented AMB, which is outdated. Now that same word has been given in recent Rockwood and Green as well. But still we see a lot of patients coming to the age of 62 having had EMP in Madurai and the surrounding places. But still I am sure it's throughout the country as well. But Dr. Magu and others may be able to substantiate that point also. Again, surgical timing. Bhandari et al. Mortality rate is 30% in elderly hip fractures. She got 41% mortality when surgery was delayed more than 48 hours. So it's very important that you must use an emergent basis as well, even in the elderly, young elderly also. The correlation between surgical timing, medical comorbidities and mortality has been thoroughly highlighted in the literature. Given the mortality rates associated with uncontrolled comorbidities, the current recommendation for patients admitted with active medical issues is optimization prior to surgery, despite potential delays. In conclusion, fracture neck of femur is the young must be managed properly as osteoarthritis and non-union rates are very high. And in the young, fracture pattern, surgeon's factor, and patient's factor all lead to complication. High energy trauma again lead to osteonecrosis. At all costs, the head must be preserved in the young patients. In the elderly, in type 1, community ambulators, type, yeah, best thing is THA, cemented or uncemented, cemented or cemented modular bipolar. Type 2, where the cognitive impairment is very bad, major medical comorbid is there, probably he may do a unipolar hemiarthroplasty, where the expectancy of life may be 3 months, 6 months, like that. What is the future? With better understanding of the fracture pattern and many meta-analysis management, we do not need to call this anymore as unsolved fracture, as said by Sholashtri. Okay. Prediction for fracture necrosis, invasive. What is the future? Again, super selective angiography can be done, intraosseous oxygen pressure measurement can be done, Doppler laser hemodynamics measurement. All this has been done by Sholashtri when I met him in Coimbatore last month also. Non-invasive, again, you can do an imaging dynamic MRI that has come into vogue now, or PET scan. The diagnostic therapeutic approach using early dynamic vascular imaging should be the target in future. Dynamic MRI or CT perfusion scan also can be done. If one can assess the vascularity of head in a displaced fracture neck, a femur in a young, we can prevent osteonecrosis occurrence by doing a vascular bone graft immediately during internal fixation or going for a THA in the initial stages itself. Future, the role of platelet-rich plasma in management of fracture neck femur, there's an article in the International Orthopedics. There is a PRP plus internal fixation group, marginal good healing, further study is essential. That is what I have. Ahmed Swami in his article says that. The role of stem cells must also be explored. We must minimize the reoperation rates after treatment of fracture neck femur in all age groups. THA seems to be the choice of treatment in old patients and also in failed internal fixation in young patients with absent neck. Clinical research is required to provide evidence on the arthroplasty choices associated with the best functional outcome. Cost cutting, again, cheap implants are considered a priority in our country, which must be avoided if possible. We cannot assume that generic implants will be identical to those which they are intended to replicate. We must be a safe surgeon. Patient must be happy with operation, no revision surgery. Take home message, in the elderly with a fractured neck or femur, ideal is no music is coming. Anyway, doesn't matter. This lady had undergone DHA and stand and dancing with the music and all that, which unfortunately is not working. Now that's the take home message. In the young patient, the patient must be able to walk on his own head. Original head, which is must be wired. Thank you for your patient hearing.